average dirt enthusiast. Do you like sticks? Do you have any interest in wood or salt? Hey, why do flies like cows? Do you have any self-awareness? I think you have some tumors back there.
Hi, baby. Hi, sweetheart. Aww.
Pigs are pretty horrifying, actually.
Okay, so I went to a farm recently, and I met what I consider to be the single greatest cow ever invented. I mean, this is the cow. If you want to look for, like, a shining example of a cow, like, not only a moral pillar, but a real anatomical, biological pillar. Look no further than, I mean, okay. I can't endorse the whole breed because, to be honest, I'm not exactly sure what kind of breed it is. There was a similar cow present that I know the breed of. It's a black Angus. But you look at the Angus cattle, they look like fucking rhinos. And so I went through a list of every kind of cow breed. There are a lot, and none of them are exactly quite what I'm looking for. The Holsteins, I gotta be honest here, are basically misshapen horses.
Let him
grow. I know that they, you know, some people would say, oh, that's the cow right there. That's what I think of when I'm a cow. Those people have applesauce for brains and should be buried up to their necks in an anthill. But Holsteins are, yes, very commonly used in dairy. But the reason I call them misshapen horses is because they have very horseish heads, but they just look a tad sillier and the ears are a bit mousier. And they have short hair that clings to their weirdly shaped frames, and I don't want to spend any more time talking about them.
The horses? Hey, how do you feel about this bullshit, huh? Oh, sorry.
So in terms of head shape, my guy, or gal, I suppose, is about halfway between a Holstein and a Hereford. Herefords have notoriously square heads, and pretty nice and woolly, too. These are a really friendly-looking bunch of cows, but let's face it, at the end of the day, their heads are shaped like erasers. And so, my guy actually falls like a very, very good balance between, you know, being a complete blockhead and, I mean, I love Herefords, but being just the most, like, dumb-looking, like, stupid, like, square-headed piece of shit. What other kinds of cows are there? Limousin? Limousin was actually a strong contender until I looked closely and I noticed they all looked like giant turds, but I guess in terms of, like, average kind of, you know, cowishness, what I need to emphasize is I keep, you know, trying to say, oh, this is, like, the average cow, the standard cow. This is such a far cut above all cows is what you need to understand, but the way it does it, it doesn't do it like most Anguses do by being, you know, Arnold fucking Schwarzenegger.
Hell yeah.
It just takes a very comfy, recognizable style, and you look at it and you're like, Jesus, how could any animal look more like a cow? And then it does everything just better.
Hey, how do you feel about this song?
Look at the coat. The coat is curly, slightly curly, which I couldn't find on any Anguses. Usually it's just full-on woolly or it's straight and short, but this is so pristinely done. It's waves. Can we just, like, say it right now? He has waves, he has drip, he has ice. It looks like the pattern was hammered into a sheet of iron.
This happened to me once.
But you got feathers like that?
No.
Your hair, like, got like that?
Mom, what are you talking about?
He has beautiful eyes. He is a female, but for the sake of boyship, we are going to gloss over that. He has wonderful white eyelashes and this peach-colored eyelids and, like, peach around the nose and the most luscious tail. When I think of a cow's tail, I don't know if this is anybody else. When I think of a cow's tail, I think of, like, a rope with, like, a little end on it that looks like it had been chewed by a cat. And this is just, like, Jesus. I didn't know I was going to the farm to see Tangle. Her name is Rapunzel. Her name is not Tangle. You really got to stop and look at this thing. The subtle curve of its head. The way it has it, like, a cute little bump of a nose. The way it has that adorable little curly hair. But it's not it's not something to be, you know, patronized or looked down upon. It's handsome. This is a really handsome cow, and it's certainly a cow that really knows what it's doing, because, you know, I interacted with this thing. I actually spent quite a fair bit of time with it. This is not a naive or easily susceptible to ad campaigns cow. This is a very sophisticated but humble cow. I cannot emphasize how unpretentious this cow is. And let's just say it's some nice udders, okay? Fucking kill me in the comment section for that, but I could not leave that stone unturned.
Hey, can you do take a picture of those horses over
I'm
there?
Sorry, I have no storage space.
Look, it even has this awesome little throat thing that just really adds to like its like general shape and just creates like a little bump of like texture, I guess, makes it more interesting overall, makes it neater to look at. The thing that separates this from a lot of cows is a lot of cows have, basically actually almost all mammals have, you know how greyhounds that have that like horrifying like chest indent? All mammals pretty much have that to varying degrees. Like sometimes the rib cage is a lot less prominent, sometimes it's a lot more. This cow does not have a rib cage. This man is a square, okay? This is a square, and that is beautiful. When something can be massive and simplistic and surrounded by all kinds of creative, subtle features, like the wonderfully sculpted head or the very nice legs, but the center is just this, like, laughably sturdy, self-confident wedge, then that is amazing. That is phenomenal, actually. Anyone who studies amateur principles of design could tell you as much.
Wow. Cool.
That is by far the worst animal I've ever seen.
What? If you don't like this cow, well, this is America, and you're entitled to your opinion, but I am also entitled to your heart in a vase. Thanks for watching, everyone. You and I are seriously just cowing. Good night. Go with the rage and blur.